The following exercises are suitable for these prosthetic knee joints. Apart from that, always consider the user's physical condition. Thanks to Genium and Genium X3, the user is able to walk upstairs step over step. A certain movement pattern is necessary to trigger stairs and obstacle function. At first, this pattern is trained with the contralateral leg, ideally using an open step. Both feet are placed under the step. Rika has to pull the foot backwards and then move it forward and up to place it on the step. To better learn the movement, a sheet of paper should be whipped backwards. The movement occurs first backwards with weight on the leg and contact with the floor. Then forward and up in the hip flexion direction. To trigger stairs function, the prosthesis has to be loaded first. If the user is having difficulties at the step, the pattern can be trained without a step first. At the beginning, it's okay to over-exaggerate the movement. The goal is to perform the pattern with the least effort possible. After triggering the function, the prosthetic knee blocks in the flexion direction and therefore supports foot placement and stepping up. A good socket fit is the prerequisite for using the function. In the second step, the focus is on foot placement. Foot, knee, and hip are aligned in the direction of movement. The foot has full contact to the step, making it easier for Rika to step up. A mark on the step board helps for correct positioning. Placing the full foot on the step provides a biomechanical advantage for stepping up. If the foot is correctly placed fully on the step, the center of mass should move forward and up. Therefore, it is easier for Rika to actively extend the residual limb when stepping up. As long as the prosthesis is loaded, the knee remains blocked in flexion direction. Franziska explains in which situations the stair function is aborted and the knee joint releases. After triggering the function, it happens if the prosthesis is unloaded or the foot is interrupted or repositioned. Additionally, the stair function is aborted with backward rotation of the lower leg. In case Rika loses balance and the center of mass moves backwards, the knee joint flexes against the hydraulic stance flexion resistance. If the prosthesis is not loaded after triggering stairs function, the joint won't block in the flexion direction. Franziska explains that Rika can use the same motion pattern to step over small obstacles. First, the pattern is trained in the standing position, and later out of walking. The obstacle function equates to the stairs function. The following exercise is a trust-building step. After triggering the function, the foot is just placed on the forefoot. Rika should take a step over the blocked and flexed knee joint. Franziska supports foot placement. Rika feels that the prosthetic knee joint is blocked in the flexion direction and she can fully load it.